So excellent, and I think your passion really touches us when we love you for that. We may agree, disagree, but your passion really, really touches us. Before I open it to the audience, one question from my side. We all know that media, and it's such a strong pillar for our democracy, is how independent, say on a scale of 10, how independent is Indian media today? What are the pressures you get in your newsroom?
The only pressure I feel is from my reporters, from my journalists, from my desk. When we choose stories, in deciding what we run, in accommodating the stories of the day, in finding time and in pushing reporters. That's the only pressure I face. Surprisingly enough, the pressure that people speak about all the time, which is political pressure, bureaucratic pressure, stakeholder pressure, advertising pressure. Now, either everybody likes me or everybody hates me, but nobody calls me. So I'm fine with that. The pressure I feel is the how to accommodate so many stories and this classical dispute on what to play. Like last night, I felt I made a mistake. I spent time talking about the Uttar Pradesh family saga, where I felt I should have started with the Right to Pray movement, which had greater social significance. That's the most pressure that I feel, Amita, most honestly. Yeah.
Okay, now before I open it to the audience, just one more. So what do you drink? Do you have a Bonvita or a Complan? Where do you get all that energy from? What's the secret of that?
Yeah. Warm water, honey, two elaiches, one long, right? You know the mix, right?
Yeah.
We call it hot toddy. We have hot toddy, not the alcoholic toddy, guys, because it's the non-alcoholic toddy which keeps me going.
Okay, excellent. So now we do open to our audiences. Please raise your hands and please make it a question rather than a very longish statement. Introduce
Those
yourself.
Are only for me. Those are only for
me. Okay. So introduce yourself. You know Arnab can't hear long.
Okay. I'll keep it short. My name is Karan.
Hi, Karan.
What do you mean by an
Can you introduce yourself?
Sorry, my name is Karan Bedi. I work with Eros Now, which is an OTT entertainment platform. So my question to you is, what do you define as an independent media? You know, today you're part of a large media conglomerate. You know, other news channels may either be part of conglomerates or independent businesses that have shareholders and so on. So what do you mean by independent?
Independent, Karan, is basically where you are responsible to the story. You know, where running a story is based upon the worth of a story. So you're not going to worry about who it's going to upset. If the story is worth it, then you run it. It's as simple as that. It's not complicated really. So independent, there'll always be shareholders and there'll be people. But if you follow up on what I later said, I said I believe that independent media should also be content run, content managed. You know, it's great if that happens. So I think it's a derivative of your viewership, how many people watch you. So it's fine. I mean, I really don't know the clear answer to what is independent media. For me, the independent media is where the story rules. And the story is king. By story, I mean news event and coverage of a story. Yeah.
Hi, Arnab. My name is Noor, right here. Very short.
Hi, Noor.
Hi. Awesome, awesome, everything you said. Loved your point. Time Warner should have bought AT&T. Even in new media, we have seen Verizon buy out AOL and Yahoo. I want to understand that what is going to happen between now to the next 3 years when you see money becoming an enabler versus the difference between success and failure.
Yeah.
Because you know what's happening with Twitter too. They're literally in a bad position because they don't have a business model, but they're all about the content. So what's going to change? Yeah,
yeah. No, I'm not questioning a business model. All media needs business models to survive. When I say money is an enabler, simple thought is this, Noor, that my experience, and we can have a offsite conversation, my experience is nobody can pay a lot of money and win the media game. See, the greatest concern that is discussion that is going on in Indian media today, people with deep pockets are coming in and buying out media. You can't do that. Historically, it's been proven. Otherwise, it would be like, you know, anybody could just put up a factory. Media is not that. Media is, as Karan asked rightly, you know, it's about the independence that comes from your soul. So, well, I mean, money being an enabler, I mean that if let's put it simply, you have 10 rupees or you have 100 rupees won't make a difference. If the basic minimum is 10 rupees, you can still beat the 100 rupee guy. You understand what I mean? That's it. That's as simple as I believe in it. I believe in it. And my support is for the startups. My support are for those journalists who are trying to do it without money. I have a lot of friends in the digital ecosystem, many of whom criticize me all the time, but I support them because what they're trying to do is different and it's unique. We have associations with people, with groups, with small websites. I support them. I evangelize them. I go out there and I speak for them because we need those people. They are part of the big Banyan tree. So I want to build that Banyan tree, which is an ecosystem for all independent journalists in some way. And I believe, Noor, you are a watcher of media trends. This is when it's going to happen because the millennial generation has woken up now. These are the guys who have never in their entire life, from their waking up years, never seen a country without a cell phone. You and I saw cell phones in our working years. That millennial generation are becoming revenue earners and wage earners now. And they are the people who will matter. That millennial generation believes in the digital ecosystem. So I support the digital ecosystem. And it's part of creating an independent media where money ceases to matter, where content is king.
Yeah. Hi Arno, my name is Sarthak Bhagat. I represent the Odisha Television Network.
Hi.
You recently mentioned some hospital and the stories that you covered. And my question is, how can regional media and regional news channel play a bigger role in getting the thought of independent media together and getting this one
you're
consolidated?
From OTV?
That's right.
Yeah, so I'll give a clear example. We worked with OTV in the coverage of the SUM hospital crisis. When I begin to feel that you are not my competitor, Sarthak, you are here, we are here to partner together. And if I work together with people like you, we can cover the news better. We just need to be less mindful, less watch over our shoulders. I'm willing to partner with anyone who supports good journalism or independent journalism. It doesn't mean that the person has to agree with my views on issues. But if you believe that you are a group of journalists doing something good, we should collaborate because our collective strength is stronger than the power of money, Sarthak. Our collective strength as journalists. What happens problematically is that we let ideological differences between journalists divide journalists. We begin to believe this person leans towards BJP anti-Congress and we begin to divide each other on the basis of our ideologies. Why should journalists have one point of view on JNU? They may not. Why do we expect all journalists to have the same point of view? They may not. But can they work together, collaborate together? They should, they must. It is their responsibility to their society. We need to work together. Otherwise, it's only money that's going to matter. Money is an enabler, Sarthak. Journalists are stronger than that. So we should collaborate. Imagine regional channels, digital ecosystem. We already have something going. We'll talk, but this is going to happen in the next 3-4 years, Sarthak.
Hi, Arnab. My name is Latika.
Hi, Latika.
Hi. Just like you said that media has power, but there's a saying, with great power comes great responsibility. Superman said that. So, my point is, you have the power, but who is the one responsible? Who is making sure that you are doing your work responsibly? Money is an enabler. It's not an obstacle anymore for you. But who is the one guiding you? Who is the one keeping an eye that everything that goes out in the country is right?
Well, I think it's the audience out there. Because, you know, in our business, I mean, I don't want to give specific examples. If you lose your credibility, you lose everything. And there are enough instances of journalists who have stumbled, right? So I think it's most important to guard your own credibility. And therefore, the viewer is very unforgiving also. The moment the viewer begins to realize that what you're saying is motivating, he's going to reject you. He or she is going to reject you. So I think the regulator, I keep saying we don't need a government regulator. I told this to Ambika Soni when we had a fairly sort of strong conversation after the scams. I said, we don't need you, ma'am. And they said, no, you need statutory regulation. We are actually empowering you. I said, you don't need statutory regulation. It's like a bitter pill I don't need to swallow. I'll regulate myself. Okay, I'm bad, I'm ill-mannered, I'm not always good, and I'm indisciplined, but I'm still better at regulating myself than somebody sitting in the government. So I think my regulator is the viewer.
Okay.
Yeah.
Thank you.
Thank you.
The last two, because Arnav has to catch a flight.
No, it's all right. Sorry, it's okay.
I'll give. Yes.
Yes.
Yeah, thank you very much. My name is Mary Ojimi.
Hi, Mary.
I'm from South Sudan, Africa continent. I'm also one of the journalists. I'm a crime reporter or human rights reporter. I'm being happy for what you have said, but I have very simple questions to you. As you know, the media is an orphan.
Is it?
An orphan.
Okay.
It has no parent. And you know, most of the issues we put to the politicians who are main insurance. In that situation, based on your experience, what can you advise your appeal? As you said, you can change the world. What can you advise your fellow journalists, like in my country, South Sudan, or in Africa, on reporting crime issues?
That's a very specific question. Thank you for your question. You know, I don't have knowledge in detail, sir, of your country, so it won't be appropriate for me to answer. But I'll just say one thing with you. Last year, I said this in Moscow. There was a conference at Russia Today. And I said then that one thing where we can collaborate on, especially Africa and Asia, because I'm talking about creating a global news ecosystem out of India, is to challenge the hegemony that has existed for far too long of the BBC and the CNN and Western media outlets in covering the world. They've sort of have greater share of voice in representing the views of the world. We need to work together to restore the balance of power. So just like I told Sarthak out there, that regional channel journalists and me, we can all work together, despite the language we are reporting in, to create a stronger network of collaboration. We can create a network of collaboration between countries that are underrepresented by the hegemonistic media powers in the US and the UK. So what we can work towards is changing that balance of power in the world. Because, you know, it's so unfair that these are the same organizations that allowed the Iraq war to happen, saying that Saddam has weapons of mass destruction. They had no proof of that. And they are the ones who teach us what neutrality, objectivity, and good norms of journalism are. I'm completely shocked. CNN was a handmaiden at that point of time for the American establishment. I think our media is far more objective. So we should find ways to collaborate, sir, on that. Maybe it will happen sooner than we think, sir. It's a thought you've left with me. Thank you, sir.
Yeah. May I take the turn now?
Sir.
Okay. Well, I am Anil Verma from Chairman Anand Group of Industries. I appreciate your spellbound speech. It was really fantastic. But one thing I would sum up your speech is, it was all idealism about journalism. How many of you, or how many you yourself, have visited border to report first-hand information? It's all fabricated, hard news. How many of you have had first-hand information by reporting happenings at border?
Sir, thank you for your question. Can I ask you, if you've never flown a plane, you can't report a hijack? That's my answer to you, sir. I've not worn a uniform or been at the border. Though I'm an army officer's son, I have no pretensions of that. But it's not something I need to do every day. If you want me to shift my studio to the border, it would be a logistical nightmare. But with the greatest of respect, sir, don't doubt what we do. Don't doubt what we do. Because there's nothing much we gain materially or personally by putting things out. We do it because we believe it. So if you are questioning our position on Pakistan, for example, or Kashmir, sir, it comes from my core. Because we also have made mistakes. And I have seen tragedies and known people. I have a very strong association with the defense forces. So maybe it comes from this. I don't disagree with someone who has other point of view, but my point of view is completely prejudiced and biased towards my own country. I'm happy to say that. And if people say, sir, that's why I say I'm not a Wikipedia of journalism. There are some great journalists in our country. I'm sorry, I'm not as great as them. Let's say remain objective between India and Pakistan. You know, sir, what I call them? I call them fence sitters. I'm not going to be a fence sitter when it comes to national interest. And if that is their vision of objectivity, I reject that definition of objectivity. But I don't have any motivations in doing what I do, sir. Believe me, that's the most I can say. I hope you believe me, that's all.
Okay, sir. One last one, Vidya. Vidya Sagar, yeah.
Do you see a scenario of...
Okay, we'll come there.
Do you see a scenario of you getting sacked, or does this come to your mind?
Of my getting sacked?
Sacked, and does
it won't matter at all, sir. I'm a free man. According to news reports, I should have walked in here with 30 security guards. Did you see any?
Yeah. Where is your
head? That's a load of rubbish that was printed last week. Sir, the thought of getting sacked never matters to me because I am not attached to anything. And today I don't need anybody and anything to reach the audience. So if I live in the mortal fear that I will get sacked, then I will not be able to do my job. I will only be sacked if ever at all by my audience, the people. I cannot be sacked by anyone else. That is something I'll tell you from my course. I don't care, sir. These are issues which don't worry to me, sir. They don't worry me at all.
Okay, let me be partial towards girls. Is there anybody? Is there a girl? Okay, please, just the last one, or maybe last two. You're not a girl, but never mind. We'll take it. We'll take it. Please. So Arnab, before they, I'll come back later. Yeah, please introduce yourself.
I'm Anand Pradhan from Indian Institute of Mass Communication. Arnab, you are saying that for me, country is first, nation is first, and I'm biased towards my nation or country. As far as I know, in journalism, truth is first obligation for any journalist. And if CNN or BBC or any global news organization is also biased towards their country and you are criticizing them because they were supporting American invasion to Iraq, why same thing is not applying to you? If country is wrong on certain issues, it is the job of journalists also to challenge that here my country is wrong. If America is wrong in Vietnam, journalists or newspapers in America must challenge that. And you know, many citizens, newspaper journalists, they challenged America. And because of that, America has to withdraw its forces. So in certain cases, yes, as a journalist, we must stand for truth. That is what I wanted to say.
Sir. Anand, I don't know what you're talking about, but drone attack kill thousands every day in Pakistan. I don't think the Americans have gone back, so your facts are wrong on that. Weapons of mass destruction till now have not been found. And nobody's sort of taken it up as an institutional campaign beyond corrective mechanisms in their own organizations. So on that also you are wrong. As far as your view, saying that, you know, you should not be biased towards your own country, I respect your view. You have a right to be sort of objective between India and Pakistan. I believe my country is a victim of terrorism that originates from Pakistan. It's as simple as that. I'm not going to complicate that fact by arguing for the fact that terror groups in Pakistan are also targeting people in their own countries. It's unfortunate that they do. So when Peshawar happens, we condemn it. But I'm going to remain slightly more focused on the problems in our own country. As far as your definition of journalism is concerned, Anand, I challenge it and I reject it. Because I will ask you one question in turn. In a question where facts are all there, right? Right and wrong, black and white. Should I remain a fence sitter? By the same logic out there, remember, Anand, that even today, some cases related to Nirbhaya have been going on till a few weeks back and a few months back. And people have interviewed the rapist and allowed him an opportunity to give his point of view saying he's innocent. And such documentaries have been aired on BBC. I don't believe in objectivity that says I should be objective between the pain of a rape victim and the defense of a rapist. That same logic. If there is right and wrong, black and white, facts stare you in the face, Anand. People were killed in Uri, Anand. Don't forget that. And don't reject the Pakistani hand in it. And don't tell me that Asia Andrabi did not call Hafiz Shaheed. She called him. And don't tell me Hawala money has not been tracked to the Hurriyat guys. It has. So don't tell me to be objective to these people. Because when you're objective for far too long, it begins to hurt your own interests. So on the issue of terrorism, I disagree with you. I would request you, Anand, go back into the facts of how some Western media organizations have reported on cases like Iraq and Afghanistan. It will open up your eyes that the same people who lecture us are sometimes the most flawed in their implementation of journalistic ethics. But I respect your right to have your opinion. Remember, I will always caveat this by saying, you are welcome to my debate. But I won't treat you with kid gloves, Anna. Then you're welcome to my debate. Okay, thank you.
Okay, I think we need to close this here because we're running into the next session.
Thank you.
Just one very last one from my side. Is there any interview which you conducted and it left you having to change your views because you normally have strong views on things? So something which happened and you actually ended up changing your view.
On the 17th, I think, of January 2014, I interviewed Rahul Gandhi.
Need you say more?
It changed my views.
Okay. Let's end at that.
Thank
we
you.
All can keep guessing the views.
Thank you so much.
Thank all
you.
The very best in your endeavor
thank
for
you
making
much.
India
thank you.
Hopefully as a hub for global news.
Thank you.
But
thank
yes,
you.
We will not wait three to four years for
I,
having you
I
back
I would only
again.
Say that whenever the change happens, you must all come out and support good journalism in this country. Like I said to Anand out there, I disagree with him greatly, but I greatly defend and respect his right to stand up and question me. So this is what makes our democracy great. I hope we have your support for the journalism that we do. We don't need to agree with anything. But let's make this country a global media superpower in the next 3 to 4 years. The time has come and it's easier than you think. So thank you very much for that. Thank you.
Thank you, Arnab.